First case we have this evening is CU 202301. Mr. Mark.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is a conditional use request by Robert Ryan for a moving and storage services business in highway commercial zoning, CH. Subject property is located at 434 Continental Road. As you see on the map on the screen, it is CH with a lot of its neighboring properties. One little parcel of RP to the west. Like they talked about at the work session, this whole intersection area on the northwest corner of Bemis and Connell has somewhat of a convoluted history. The zoning pattern actually predates the parcel pattern. And so there's a lot of interesting little things that went on, one of which is a lot of commercial uses, mainly automotive related, that have been built on these properties over the years. That predates our character area. Subject property is Neighborhood Activity Center, which under today's standards would not allow CH zoning, but the CH zoning is already there. Its grandfathered in is not compliant, which is why it and its neighboring property have got all motive type uses that normally would not be allowed in that location. Aerial imagery, you see the rooftops of some of the buildings that were built. These two parcels at Connell have very big backyards that are currently undeveloped. One of them has commercial zoning, and the other one does not. Actually, the backyard is commercial. To the subject property, it looks like this from Connell Road on a nice rainy day when I was posting the sun. You see the storefront, but also bays from its automotive use days. And then on the east side, the pathway to the back, the applicant has already moved into the site and they've parked their trucks in the back. As talked about in the staff report, which we'll get to in a moment, you see they are using what they call box trucks or furniture trucks. These are not the tractor trailer variety that we sometimes see with moving and storage businesses. Adjacent properties, it's across the street from Morningside Baptist Church, which is the south. This is the view looking west down Connell Road. Which you see signage of some institutional and office uses, apartments on down the street. To the east at the corner of Venus Road, this is the back side of the Gray Norton automotive repair business. And then this is the neighboring property, which is Ross Automotive, which is on the property to the west. This is the side view looking into their service space. Boundary survey and site plan together are in your packet. See the existing building, parking in the front, a lot of extra paving. They're proposing simply to move into the building, maybe do some renovation on the inside. There's a covered canopy in the back, I think it's about 1,200 square feet. The building itself is about 3,400 square feet, and then they're showing some parking spaces in the back. You also see your packet review comments from the city engineer, who is requesting that if it's regular truck parking, it needs to be on regular paved surface, like other parking, and that's something to be looked at during the review and licensing process. But they've got plenty of room on the site. The use fits in given the zoning that's there, the buildings that are there, and the history of the property. So with all of that, staff is finding consistent and comprehensive plan, the conditional use review criteria, recommending approval subject to four conditions. First one is approval shall be granted in the name of the applicant only. Your report says application, I want to correct that to applicant. For moving and storage services business in CH zone, the total building area under roof not to exceed 7,000 square feet. That's a few thousand square feet more than what they have now, so it would allow a little minor expansion to the back, whether it be the main building or just a carport or something. All buildings shall be one story and not exceed a height of 20 feet. There shall be no outdoor storage of any kind that is not under roof. Number two, there shall be no large trucks with more than two axles, and all trucks shall be parked on paved surfaces as required by the city engineer. Third, a minimum 20-foot wide buffer yard consisting of at least six small trees and two canopy trees for 100 linear feet shall be planted along the north property line above PRD6 zone. And is approved by the city arbors. Existing trees will account for the buffer yard calculations, and shrubs shall be considered optional in this buffer yard area. After we talk about the work session, that's actually in deference to the applicant. certain redevelopment things, expansions on the property, would trigger a standard buffer yard, which between CH and R6 zoning is a 30-foot buffer yard with trees and shrubs. This condition of approval reduces that to 20-foot buffer yard and the trees on it. So it begins to put a buffer against the rest of the area, but not at full 40-foot effect. Number four, conditional use approval shall expire 1 year from the date of approval if no city business license has been obtained by that date. I'm glad to answer any questions you may have.
Thank you, Matt. Commissioners, any questions for staff?
I have a question. I'm just curious. So he's got existing about 34 feet of covered space that he could use for storage right now. Just so I can understand this, are we saying that his 1.5 acres that he has now, that he's allowed to do another 3,600 square foot building to do accumulation of 7,000, or what are you saying there?
Well, it includes the covered canopy as well, so it's really about 5,000. So yeah, it allows expansion onto the building, maybe closing the canopy and moving on, or putting a separate freestanding building back where the trucks are now.
So so is the acre and a half that's in the back, is it greater than what we're using right now, do you know?
Well, I'm just curious why we're limited to the screen. It looks almost like 60-40.
Yeah, I'm just curious why we're limited to 7,000 total feet with another acre and a half in the back.
Because of the use. This is the first time we've approved of moving a storage business. If he wants to expand beyond these numbers, it would come through this process again. And then at that time, we'd have a track record to go on and see how it works. Same thing with the sizes of the trucks. If he wants to go into the big rigs, then it's a whole different discussion. I had a lot of concern about that, as did engineering, with the very large trucks using Connell Road. That could be a problem. Direct access to Venus would work a lot better for that. But this is really to get them in business, expand a little bit, see how it goes, if they want to go beyond and use the rear yard for this same use, then it's another conditional use review. Otherwise, the rear yard is CH, conceivably, perhaps another commercial use factor. But the moving and storage business is what would have the limitation.
Any other questions for staff? We will now enter the public hearing portion of this case. Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak in favor of this case? If so, please come forward. State your name and address for the record, please.
I'm Robert Wright, 503 Trees Drive, Lake Park, Georgia. And I think we've covered every question that needs to be. If there's something else you need to know, I'd love to, if there's something you're concerned with, I'd love to hear it. They're very thorough in what they do, so I'm impressed with what they do. So pretty much eliminates any misunderstanding.
Mr. Reiner, could you address Commissioner Bailey's question? Are you good with limiting yourself to 7,000 square feet under roof?
Well, we did that because it was their suggestion for future. If something happened, they wanted to go ahead, and if it did, I had no intention of immediately of doing this. And actually, if I would have to act, I'd probably speak with a realtor to see what the best use of that property was.
Okay.
I was concerned to start off with about the access, and he discussed it with me, and he said, you have plenty of access down the side to put in office building. So I didn't know, and
okay.
For his benefit, I just want, he knows what he's talking about, so I okay. Follow his lead.
So you're okay with just limiting to 7,000 square foot?
Yes.
At this time? Okay,
yeah.
Thank you.
Mr. Brown, you're also, as you go forward, you're just have the two actual box trucks and not going in kind of semi-rigs or anything?
No, there'll be no semi-rigs.
No.
I no CDL drivers. I don't want anything that big or that bulky. It's just too much for that area, too much for on me.
Okay, cool.
Thank you,
Mr. Grimer.
Thank you.
Is there anyone else here this evening that would like to speak in favor of this case? Please come forward and state your name and address for the record.
Good evening, Stephanie Gonzalez. My address is 1333 Edgewood Drive, Valdosta, Georgia. I'm the GM for Griner Moving Services, so if you have any questions for me, I do the day-to-day business for Mr. Griner, so I might be able to help you a little bit more if you have anything else that you didn't get from Mr. Griner, and I obviously speak in favor.
Obviously.
I need to stop that. I have six kids. Help me out, guys.
Any questions for Ms. Gonzalez or?
Consolis.
Consolis.
Yes.
And you're okay, and you, because since you're the day-to-day person there with the approximately 7,000 square feet, I mean, so that gives you a little room for expansion, but you think you're good to go with that?
I think so. I think that for now, for the foreseeable future, that would be a reasonable amount if we were to need to expand. I think that if it ever were to need more, like Robert, you know, discussed, that I think that we would come back and work on that. But I think it's a good idea to start. Just, you know, inching out a little bit more.
Baby steps.
Yeah.
Baby steps. Good deal.
Yes, sir. We agree.
Anything else for the speaker? Thank you, Ms. Consolis.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak in opposition to this case? If so, please come forward. Anyone who would like to speak in opposition to this case? Hearing none, that will close the public hearing portion of this case, and I will go back to the commissioners for any comments, if they may have, or a motion.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, Commissioner Wiles.
I'd like to make a motion regarding this conditional use request, CU 2024-01, for moving and storage services in a commercial highway zone. As staff explained, this has been found to be consistent with comprehensive planning, and there have been four conditions added to make it more amenable. So I'd like to make a motion that we request approval.
Thank you for that excellent motion.
I'll second that, Mr. Chair.
Seconded by Commissioner Bailey. All in favor of the motion? Any opposed? I think that was unanimous, Mo.